Hello, younger old here, welcome to my channel and welcome to my shed. A few weeks ago, as a man who cannot resist a bargain, I bought a motorcycle table lift and hardly ever been used, and it was a good price. And this was the clamp thing which come on it. Obviously you turn that in there, basically it grips your bike tire. Problem is, this height here is too high and it actually catches the bottom of the disc. Now okay, you could just cut it off, but I've decided to try and make some modifications and actually make it more secure. So I thought, okay, we'll have a go. I'm not going to use it as it is, and to buy the one I like is really expensive, actually 50% more than I paid for the lift. So stay tuned and let's see what happens. Okay, so the next phase I've done is, as you can see, I've basically drilled two holes there, drilled all the way through, and we've got a piece of steel in. Now obviously that's going to be packed out with wood and rubber yet. The only thing is, the angle was leaning too far this way, so I wouldn't really touch the tyre. So I've had to basically cut this little nick out here of the lip. And now the actual steel sits in at a better angle. As you can see, I've got an extra hole there, which is an optional extra, but when that's covered over, you won't see that anyway. So that's sort of the next stage of the project. So let's see what else happens. Right, now I'm just going to add another coat of primer. Just don't forget, always wear a mask when you're doing this so you don't breathe these fumes in. Yeah, I'm just going to put a very light coat of black on just to start it off. You just hate it when that happens. Can of paint ran out. Let's go and get another tin. Right, try again. Another tin of paint. Well, that's the final coat of paint on. I'm using black, A, because I've got loads of tins knocking about, and B, you know, I'm not riding around on it. It doesn't matter that the rest of it's red. It's a bike ramp at the end of the day, and the chances of getting a red to match it would be hard. So I thought, well, what the heck, let's just use some black. But there's hopefully when that dries now, it will be fine. Okay, we're still not finished yet, but it's getting there. Basically, I've got the steel supports in. Not sure whether to cut these bolts off yet, or nuts off I should say. The other thing is, if I need to make anything wider, I might need that. So I should probably leave that for the time being. The wood's in place. Obviously, got to recess there with a 16mm spade bit in this case, so I could actually sink the heads of the nut. Then obviously this is all going to be covered in rubber. This is being glued on and screwed on, bolted, and then I've got all around the edges here with black mastic, up these gaps here with black mastic. Not sure what to do with the top yet. It's either get a plastic thing to fit, toying with the idea of putting actually a bar all the way through the top there as a stop bar. I've actually got one on the ramp, so might not need one on here. Just got to wait and see till it's fitted back on the ramp and then decide from there. But so far so good. Obviously as you turn that, the idea is it will grip the tyre in the middle there. The bits of wood here and the time I've got the rubber on as well is going to mean that this bit here doesn't come anywhere close to the front brake disc, so it's not going to damage the disc. And then obviously rather than just the tyre being in that bit able the bike to sway, I've got this bit up here which then should obviously help to secure the tyre better. So it's cost me absolutely nothing to do, it's all done with bits, so you know, I think it should be okay. So I'm going to get the rubber and then I'll finish the video and show the finished article when I've done it. Okay, so we're finally finished. Things which probably didn't go quite to plan was I couldn't get the rubber I wanted. It should have been a little bit thinner than this, but I thought okay, let's have a go with this. The only problem is it's probably made this gap here a little bit narrower than it should have been. There is enough room to get my bike tyre in there, but on the other hand, if it's too wide and you tie that, you've got too much winding, it's quite a narrow thread, and bearing in mind at this point you're going to be holding the bike with your right hand and you're going to be turning this with your left hand, so the fact that it has left the gap a little bit narrow, it's probably a plus thing. If I do find I need more room, I can take this rubber off. I have now actually sourced some thinner rubber, so that will only take me, you know, half hour to change should I need to. So yeah, I'm pleased with it. I had to cut this bit here off the end because obviously when it's on the ramp I want to be able to take this out. Should I not need it, it might be in the way when the bike's just resting on there with the side stand down. But obviously, with all the extra thick padding on, it wouldn't fit in there. So, hence the reason I had to just get the grinder and cut that bit off. So, I won't know exactly how it performs until it's actually on the ramp. Like I said, I want to see how this lines up with the stop bar. If it doesn't work out right, I will put a stop bar through there. So it's just now to try it and see. It just shows that, you know, you can make a modification to something and it costs literally no money, you know, just scrap bits which we're knocking about. But it's going to do the job a lot better when I've actually sort of put the bike in there, whereas before the bike did sort of rock slightly. Now obviously once it's tight, you've got these up there, it just grip the front wheel, well sorry, the front part of the tyre as well as just the bottom part, so it is definitely more stable. So yeah, time will tell, but I hope you like it and I hope you enjoyed the video. Please tick if you like it, leave any comments, it would be nice if you'd subscribe, it doesn't cost you anything. So thanks for watching, hope you enjoyed it, and ride safe, and as always, bye for now.